all the pants. We got a lot of pants, so. What's up, y'all? It's your girl, Michi, and I'm back with another video. As y'all could tell by the title, and it was very highly requested, I'm going to be doing a custom pants haul for y'all. Every pants that I've made, including the ones that I've sold that are other people's, I will be including those in here, obviously with pictures because I don't have the items anymore because, you know, they paid for them, so they have them. But I will be showing them to y'all. So here are all of the clothes, y'all. I mean, all the pants. We got a lot of pants, so. But before we get into this video, if you enjoy it, which I know you will, go ahead and subscribe down below. Like this video, comment what you want to see next, and hit the notification bell so you'll be notified the next time that I upload. Now let's just go ahead and get into it. First, I wanted to show y'all these shorts. I actually made these kind of just randomly, but they're just some regular like Walmart gray shorts, and I had these extra patches laying around. These are iron-on patches, so I just ironed them on. Obviously, they're NFL team. Well, it's really just sports teams in general, but NFL and baseball on them. I really like them. They came out cute, and I do have pictures on my Instagram in those already. So if y'all want to see that, go ahead. Check that out. The next pair of shorts are these carpet shorts. They're actually thin, so I was able to wear them during the summer. This is a thinner material, so I thought this would be perfect for some shorts. You know, it has the fringe on the side. I decided not to put fringe on the bottom part of it. They're brown. These are cute. I also have pictures in these. Now we're gonna get into the real pants. These next pair of pants that I want to show y'all, these are actually one of the first custom pants I've ever made. These are just some purple pants, and they have Cartoon Network patches all over them. I took this from a shirt and then added like the stitching to make it look like patches on there, have them going all the way down the leg, and then on the side I decided to slit it and put safety pins on the side. I don't know where or why I got that idea, but I did, so I did it, and it actually came out super cute. Every time I wear these pants, I get compliments on them. So since we're on the topic of safety pins, this is one of the recent custom pants I've made. Really, these are just regular pants that I got from the thrift store. They're corduroy red pants, and I decided to add safety pins going down the leg, kind of giving like that skeleton design kind of thing, have them going down both sides of the leg and then only going down on the pockets. There will be a try-on portion for all of this stuff, so y'all be able to see what it looks like on and everything. But I really love those pants. Those are probably one of my favorite custom pants out of all the stuff that I've made. This one was kind of just a quick little something, you know. These are just black sweatpants, but I decided to put little smiley faces on them. It's not really that much going on. It's just black and white. Just a little something different, because sometimes I just be wanting to spruce up the pants and I be bored, so why not? The only thing is though, these are my only black sweatpants, so I gotta get some more. The next pair of pants are these olive green pants that I put the fringe on the side, which is basically kind of giving like the carpet pants vibe, but these have just the fringe on the side of the pants. I actually really like these a lot. I recently wore these with a shirt that I custom made in this same print. So this was the top and this was the bottom. It's actually super cute. Again, on my Instagram, y'all can go see it. But yeah, love these pants. Love the way they fit. And I love the fringe because I've never seen nobody do it with the pants and the fringe. I think the only person I've seen was Teyana Taylor. And if I can find that picture, I'll pop it up. Next, we're gonna get into my jeans. This pair of jeans, I actually have a video on my channel. It was on the Make It Monday series, but I took a light pair and a dark pair of jeans and basically cut the sides off of the dark pair of jeans, sewed them together, so it kind of gives this type of look. And then I took extra pants because I wanted them to be a little bit bigger and kind of stacked on the bottom. So I took some of the dark pair of jeans and put it down on the bottom. I actually really like how this turned out. I kind of was really experimenting with these jeans, and they actually came out super cute. So I'm really proud of myself for that. And they're baggy, they're big. We just love to see it. Next pair of jeans, y'all have probably seen me in these before. These are half and half bleached pants that I actually did myself. Well, obviously this is a custom video, but anyways, they were this color originally, and I took a bucket of bleach, put this inside, and it came out with the design. I didn't do this on purpose. It actually came out accidentally, but it came out good. So yeah, I really love it, and I love how the bleach actually stayed right in the middle. This was just, I really love these. These are probably one of my favorite jeans ever. They fit well and everything. Next, we have this pair of jeans, which is another half and half bleach jeans. I have a video of how I did these on my channel. Again, they were this light color right here. And then when I bleached them, they turned out this color, and then the middle part just happened from the bleach. So I kind of like it because it kind of gives like a, I don't know, a fade or whatever. I really like the back of it the most because you can really see the three different colors kind of blend together. Another really good pair of jeans that everybody keeps asking me about, which I have a TikTok and I have a YouTube video on me making these pants. So go check it out. My TikTok is the same as my Instagram and the same as... actually, that's it. Next pair of jeans we have, which I think this is actually the first ever custom pants I ever made, literally. So we have these jeans. I took some black pants that I wasn't using, cut them into letters, and hand sewed these letters onto the jeans leg, and then I cut a hole in the knee. It says Michi going down the leg, and then there is fire on the ankle. I got this from a bandana and then just glued this onto the pants, and it actually came out really good. I'm actually really happy with how this came out. I was really proud of these. Everybody wanted some of these. I used to wear these in high school. I actually haven't worn them in a while, so I might have to break these out again, you know what I'm saying? So if you haven't seen them already, these are custom patch jeans that I actually did. Literally did everything by hand, y'all. These are my favorite jeans, period, out of all the jeans I have. These jeans took 2 weeks to make because I just, you know, life, I had other stuff to do. I couldn't spend literally every single day doing these, but I'll just give y'all kind of a preview of what all is on there. These are all random jean patches from old pants that I either couldn't wear anymore or didn't fit, or they were just old, and took some of them and bleached them to give it like the light blue, dark blue effect. This was from an overall that I took the little skinny strap off of, made it look like, you know, the little chains or something that hang off. And then I also took the time to every stitch, every patch, and make them different designs. Like this one has kind of a zigzag. This one has X's. This one has like kind of checkerboard sewing. Like I just really took my time with these and they came out so well. I was so happy, so proud of these. I always get compliments on these. I even added an extra pocket on the leg. And on the back, there is detailing with these pockets. I even took the time to put, like, come on now, who you know is doing that? Nobody. Because yeah, I will always wear those. I'm never getting rid of those, ever, ever, ever. The next pair of pants we have are these right here. I have a YouTube video on how I made these as well. But these were my first ever time making carpet pants, and these came out so good. I was so happy. I followed this other girl's kind of tutorial to a T, and it worked. This is what they look like. I definitely have pictures on my Instagram of these. This is very thick. This is like perfect for the fall time that's here slash coming up. I love them so much. Yeah, that's pretty much it. So once I knew how to make these and I posted a picture in them, everybody was asking for a pair of carpet pants. And you know what I did? Made it for them. I also made another pair of carpet pants, which are these right here. They're like a checker print carpet pants. If I don't have picture or video in this, there will be pictures in these soon, so definitely stay tuned for these. But I like this one a lot. This one is a little bit thinner than the first carpet pants I showed you, but I do still like them, and they are still on the thick side, if that makes sense. Also, here's the fringe. The fringe is a little bit smaller, but it has like this like nudish tannish. These are kind of different because there's just a whole bunch of random colors going on, but I found a way to style them and it's cute, so stay tuned. Okay, so now the next thing I'm going to show you is just going to be on the screen. If you've seen my recent vlog, or it might be coming out after this video, but I did just finish a custom order for somebody. Their jeans with like hearts on it. I just sent these out to him. They came out really well. I was happy with the results, but I did want to share that with y'all, show y'all what they looked like, because you know, I'm proud of my work. I can't wait for him to style them, because I'm trying to figure out, like, in my head I was trying to figure out what type of fit he was gonna come up with. If you're seeing this, shout out to you. Thank you for trusting me with your pants, your jeans. They came out good. I was happy to make them. I had fun making them. And also, I went live and showed a couple of y'all the process of it on my TikTok and on my Instagram. So if you don't follow me on either one of those, you definitely should. Stay tuned for the next video, because I'm gonna have a clip of me actually on live making those pants. Next custom pants I wanted to show y'all, I made for somebody too. They are another pair of carpet pants. They're these like rose greenish pants. I kind of featured them in another vlog kind of towards the end, but this is what they look like. I'm gonna pop a clip on the screen right now. I really, really, really liked these carpet pants a lot, like to the point where I'm thinking about making some for me, because they were just, they look so good. Definitely have fun making those. Also, since we're on the topic of just customization, this shirt I'm wearing today, I actually made. I wish I would have made a video on how I made it. So I might come out with like a TikTok or a tutorial or something on how I made it, because I got a lot of compliments on it today. And also, I'm wearing another pair of Crocs that I laced. A lot of y'all were asking, how did I lace my Crocs? It's not really that hard, really. You just put the strings through the holes. I didn't have a specific style or pattern that I used. But I did record me lacing these. So I might, again, put out a TikTok with just, you know, a little couple tips on how I did them. There might be some other custom pants I'm missing, y'all, because there's just so many and I've made so many custom pieces. It's kind of hard to keep up with it, but those are just all the ones that I have right now with me that I can think of. Also, if you do want custom pants, I will have my Instagram on the screen and down in the description. If you DM me and say somewhere in the message, have it say custom order, then I'll definitely try my best to get back with you as soon as possible. I also do more than just pants. With that being said, I think that's the end of this video, y'all. So if you enjoyed, be sure to subscribe down below, like this video, comment what you want to see next, and hit the notification bell so you'll be notified the next time that I upload. I will see y'all in the next one.